What's up, guys? Nick the Kai here. Today we got a common problem on this Sequoia. If any of you guys own this vehicle, maybe this video will be helpful to you. We have a trunk that won't open. So you can see in there, the handle is obviously broken. It's not engaging the latch. So this is a very common problem. Either the latch breaks right here or the actual latch that latches the trunk door to the car, or sometimes the cables in there break or they pop off the pins. So I'm gonna show you guys how to fix this problem. So let's hop inside the back of the vehicle and start tearing it apart. All right, so we are in the back of the vehicle right now. Luckily for us, customer kept it nice and clean because they knew we were gonna have to hop back in here. So first thing we gotta do, take off this 10, kind of holds this panel on. Since we can't open the trunk, obviously it's going to be a little bit more difficult, but still possible. We're gonna have to kind of pop these panels off, start with this top one, then one on each side right here, because you can see this panel sits behind this and this panel sits behind this one. So we're gonna start from the top, kind of just start popping them all off, and then we'll have access to the latch behind there almost. Once you have all those panels off, you can see we have another cover plate right here that's held on by a couple tens, as well as electrical connector we're gonna have to disconnect.
You gonna have lunch with me on the last day, you fucking pussy?
We got all the bolts off, unplug the connector, go into this box right here so we can just move this harness out of the way. Now we should be able to pop this off, should kind of slide up. Oh, forgot one. All right, now that we got that other bolt off, we should be able to slide it up just like that, and we could go ahead and remove this panel out of the way. Okay, so coming in here, I'm trying to show you guys the best. Right here, this cable is what the latch on the outside runs down to over here, and the latch mechanism's actually down in there. So what's happening is you're pulling the latch. Maybe I could zoom in a little bit. And this cable is not being pulled. So we're gonna try and push that ball that's on the end of the wire and that part of the latch manually, and hopefully we get it to release. I could do this while filming, but I'm gonna try. There we go. Just like that. And now our trunk is open. So then right now, since we know that obviously the latch mechanism, the striker, and the cable, everything's functioning fine, we really just need to replace the handle. But I wanted to open it just to make sure, because sometimes it's more than just a broken handle. But now that we know everything's working good, we just gotta replace that latch, so. All right, so we got our part right here. Here's the part number for any of you guys who need it. But you can see this plastic piece right here that actually activates the lever, probably what broke on our vehicle over here. So now we just gotta pop it out and reinstall this one. All right, so coming to the inside, we're gonna have to take off these two 10s or 12s. There's one right here, one right there. Let's see them up there. So it's nice we got these two holes right here. We can shove an extension and that 10 in, and then we'll go from there. All right, so in order to remove the latch, we're gonna have to take off this whole little panel actually. You'll see there's these plastic tabs right here, or little pop pins coming to the inside. There's gonna be one there, another one up here, and right there. So to avoid breaking them, it's gonna be easier to kind of just squeeze them from the inside and slowly kind of wiggle that whole outside plate out. All right, so I got all the tabs pushed. You can see it's pretty much ready to come out. The only thing holding it is the lock cylinder. So we're gonna have to come under here, get this one more 10 right there, disconnect these two electrical connectors, and then that whole panel should be free to go after that. But after you do that, it should be able to come out. You technically didn't need to disconnect the lock cylinder other connector, but I just unplugged them both. And we're here, we have our latch exposed. So now all we gotta do is, there's a Phillips screwdriver screw on that side and that side, and the handle will pop right off. All right, so we have our old switch off now. Go ahead and put the new one. Put it back in where it was. And side note, you don't have to just unscrew the license plate lights. I thought you had to, but you don't. So now we just gotta screw this back on, reinstall this cover, and go from there. So when you're going back in, it's simply lining up those bolt holes and those two 10s, as well as lining up all the plastic clips, and it should be able to snap right in. Just like that. Now we have our nice feeling liftgate handle. Coming back on the inside, we'll go ahead and put the lock cylinder back in, plug it in, plug in the electrical connector for the license plate lights, as well as come in over here, and we gotta hook this cable back on. This is the trunk release cable. So if I could get in there, it's a little bit hard to see, but right here you'll hook it on, and up in there on the lever, go back to the old one. You're gonna hook the cable grommet right through this spot, and then you gotta pull that ball around in here and make sure it sits in this little corner through this notch. All right, so we got the cable hooked up. It's all bolted up. One thing I like to do before I really go any further is just make sure that the latch unlocks now when you grab the lever. You don't wanna put it all back together, so I'm gonna go ahead and put my hand up on the top and open the lever. Sweet, we're good to go. Now we have a nice operational trunk hatch. So now we're just gonna go in the reverse order. Of course, I gotta screw these lights back on. We'll put the license plate back on and the frame. And yeah, that's for the most part pretty much it. I will say one thing, be careful when you do go to put the big cover back on here. Make sure none of the plastic little rivet nuts or little, I don't even know what to call these, plastic clips got stuck in the trunk. Because sometimes that'll happen, you'll pull out the panel and some will stay in here, and then you'll just need to take them off and reinstall it on the panel. But besides that, just go in the reverse order, slap the metal cover on here, plug in these two electrical connectors, bolt it all up, slap the plastic cover on it, slap the side panels on, then the top piece, and then last but not least, the little cargo strap. So I'm pretty sure you guys can handle that. I'll go ahead and reinstall everything and show you guys the finished product. You guys can see all back together now. They're missing this cover when they brought it in, so nothing to worry about there. Sure, all the trim looks good and lined up. You don't want the customer to see it. Well, you're probably doing this on your own car, so it doesn't matter, but let's make sure repair is good. Sweet. So job well done, guys. Hope this video will help you guys fix your trunk release handle on your Sequoia. Sorry I couldn't get the best camera angles. I didn't have my tripod or anything. I just decided to film it. So I'm sure someone could probably use this video at home. So that's it for today's episode, guys. I'll catch you guys later.
Peace! Hey, Bill, I'm in the mood for a switch up. I hit the function, hit the rose till I hiccup. I hit the
stage and leave with money, that's a sticker. She picture perfect, so I told him I'ma flick.